Diocese of Stockton, thank you for joining us. I'm here with Alvira Ramirez. She's the Director of Catholic Charities in Stockton. Alvira, thanks for joining me.
Thank you, Chandler. Good morning.
So to explain to the viewers or listeners to what's going on, Catholic Charities has a lot going on. And me and Alvira were trying to rack our brains and figure out how we get this information out to the diocese. And we figured it'd be best just to sit down, record our meetings, and let everyone know what's going on. So Alvira, why don't you kind of introduce the diocese or reintroduce the diocese to Catholic Charities, where you guys are located, website, how they can get a hold of you, and then we'll get into some of the things you guys are doing.
All right. Thank you. Well, I do hope and believe that everyone is aware that Catholic Charities is active throughout the diocese, that we have an office located in Stockton, which is our administrative office, another one in Modesto, and one in Sonora. And through these offices, we are able to provide 10 different programs of service. COVID, of course, has really changed for us, as it has for many nonprofits, how we provide those services. We've reduced the in-office or in-person visits. However, we are still acting, being able to deliver all of these programs, or most of them, through remote work. So please do visit our website at www.ccstockton.org, where you would see a description of a lot of the programs I am about to describe. Or you can call our direct line for our receptionist that can then forward your call to the specific program that you might need. So I will give you the number for our office here in Stockton is 209-444-5900. And then our office in Modesto is 209-. The programs and services that really have been much in demand during these COVID months when COVID has been, affecting everyone's lives, have been like our supported services for veterans, where anyone who is a veteran who is homeless or is on the verge or at risk of becoming homeless because they can't keep up with their rent, they should call Catholic Charities. We are able to put anyone who is homeless and is a veteran in a hotel. We've been able to keep them for up to a couple of months while we are looking for permanent housing for them. The VA has really stepped up the support that we are able to provide to veterans during this time. And of course, homelessness has so many other complications that go with it. So we are connecting with other community partners. We also have a healthcare access program that assists individuals and families to sign up for Medi-Cal. So in these times when our health is, you could feel ill, and if you don't have insurance, would be such a difficult thing to get any medical treatment, please call us. We can help you to complete that process to become insured through Medi-Cal. And if you qualify for other programs through the state exchange, we would give you the information on how to do that. Our nutrition assistance program has also been very busy because, of course, as families lose employment or their hours are reduced, being able to provide food for their families has been a difficulty and a great suffering for parents, single parents and couples. So our nutrition assistance program allows us to help them enroll in the CalFresh program, which has been increased during these times of COVID to help families put food on the table. So please call us. We are very happy to help families with a bag of food if they live in Stockton. But while they're there, we're checking that if they're eligible for CalFresh to enroll them in that program. We are also able to assist families who are not enrolled in the pandemic EBT, which means that there are children who would be eligible through their schools for free and reduced lunches. Sometimes they're not enrolled in the program and they were getting food in school. Well, right now we can help make sure you connect with that pandemic EBT and your family can receive those if you don't have CalFresh as well. So those are three significant programs and services that are very relevant to families struggling to provide basic needs. I also want to talk about our COVID care program. This one has been evolving as the months went by. We basically are able to provide financial assistance to anyone who is struggling again because of illness due to COVID, or they lost their jobs, or their hours were reduced in employment, and therefore they are having difficulty meeting rent, utility bills, and other basic needs. The number for this one, I will give it, we're calling it a hotline, is 209-469-1120. And within this COVID care program, we have what is known as the Housing for the Harvest, which is particularly focused on agricultural workers. Regardless of immigration status, we are able to help any agricultural worker who is ill with COVID right now to separate, isolate in a hotel free of charge. We provide transportation, laundry service, and of course the food while they are in isolation for 10 to 14 days. Right now, the state fortunately has extended the program so that it includes our ability to help a family isolate in their home, because sometimes both parents are already infected with COVID or they've got young adults who are also affected. So it doesn't make sense to isolate in a hotel, but to stay at home, we can provide $1,000 or $500. By the way, the $1,000 is if they isolate in the hotel, $500 if they are isolating at home. And then again, we provide them with their food, maybe transportation to medical doctors or pharmacy if they need medicine. We're doing some case management of those families. So that is the Housing for the Harvest program. The other COVID special assistance, we're still connecting them with other community services and providing that $500 while they are at home trying to catch up from the impact of COVID. As you can hear, we have tried to be responsive to the needs out in the community. Our senior service programs have been the most impacted in that we are not in the homes for the safety of the seniors and the safety of our staff. However, we still are able to make regular calls. We're able to deliver food to the seniors that are in our program. So if you are 60 years and older, please call us if you are in need of food, because our transportation program can still help you get to a doctor's appointment or deliver food to your house. I think that because we understand that our parishes have not been meeting as well due to COVID, this information has not made its way to the people through the parishes. And I really appreciate that, Chandler, you are going to be able to get the word out and remind everyone that Catholic Charities is here to serve everyone. And certainly that means that the people through our parishes are able to reach out to us, and we will respond as quickly as we can.
Elvira, thank you so much for the update to the Diocese of Stockton, to the faithful throughout the diocese. We hope to give you these updates very regularly. Elvira, one more time, if someone needs to get a hold of Catholic Charities, how can they do that?
They should contact our main number at 209-444-5900. Or our Modesto office at 209-529-3784, or our Motherlode office at 209-532-7632. Those are the main numbers at our satellite and main offices, and then they will be connected with whatever service that they need. Now, today I didn't go over all of our programs. We do continue to provide legal immigration services. We have a parent support program, advanced care planning, and a very important one I should mention, of course, is our family counseling. Many people are suffering the social and emotional effect of this, a lot of depression and anxiety. So we would do our very best to respond to needs for short-term, brief intervention counseling. So.
Great. And Elvira, it's probably important to know most, if not all, of your staff's bilingual, right? So if someone calls and they speak predominantly Spanish, there's going to be no problem getting them resources or putting them in touch with the right people, correct?
Absolutely. Sí. Everyone, podemos responder en español, especialmente los números generales. Les van a dar a las personas que pueden hablar español para escuchar sus necesidades y a ver cómo les podemos ayudar.
Great. Elvira, thanks so much.
No, thank you, Chandler.